Shift's up. Can I tag you in?
Yeah. Did she sleep at all? Shit. It's 4 days.
Yeah. Can't tell where her mind is, you know? Or what made her want to take her own life.
I wouldn't waste your time wondering. Maybe her head's in the clouds. Maybe she's fantasizing about her geriatric boyfriend. What matters is she's alive and she's finally fucking quiet. Deepest apologies, but I'm not gonna be pressed over her sad little case of insomnia. You know what would have helped? A benzo. But she hoovered them all before we made her puke them out, so it looks like she dug her own grave on that one.
Yeah, Fatten, she almost did.
I'm sorry. But I'm done with her.
I don't think you mean that.
I don't.
No, I know shit talk when I hear it, and you don't mean that.
All right. Well, I had you scheduled to watch her later, but maybe I'll just pull a double shift.
Thank you. Hey. Happy to play nurse to Rachel. Yeah. If you need me to, I got all the time in the world for that one.
Let's go. I'm not gonna sit here being pitied. Let's go.
Are we feeling optimistic about that?
Absolutely fucking not.
Whoops. Look at me making a racket like some kind of amateur, I swear. I usually get a much softer foot.
Shh. You're gonna scare it. If the trap didn't hold, it might bolt out. Stay here.
Oh, you got him good, Martha.
He's a beauty.
You know, I really thought that I might be able to lend some expertise today, but
it turns out I'm a little
obsolete.
Oh, sorry.
No, don't apologize. I'm in awe. And besides, I can still provide moral support, and that's what Tony thought you might need anyway.
Tony told you to come with me?
We sort of decided together, I guess.
She was telling me about your rabbits and the shelties you used to have,
and we both just got to thinking how tough it must be. You know, loving animals the way that you do and still coming out here every day, taking on so much just so that we can eat.
What else has Tony said about me?
I don't know, lots of things, I guess. But only in the spirit of helping you out, you know? And speaking for myself, I know how hard it is to put your values aside, or change them faster than you might be ready for. We just want to be there for you.
Yeah, I know. Thanks. We should go. He's not gonna last this very long.
Starvation.
She went pliant. And the sigh she made was surrender.
Steamy, right?
Like a fresh pile of shit. I mean, an entire book about hornball wedding planners in some snobby fucking town called Greenwich, Connecticut.
Greenwich. And that's not the only one. Apparently there's 4 in the series.
4 of these turds? I can't even get 1 sequel of District 9, and the world gets 4 of these shit cakes.
Why don't you just give it a few more pages? Maybe it'll hook you. It's a hot little romp.
People actually enjoy this activity. Holding open a big stack of paper and just moving their eyes back and forth and back and forth. And...
God. Tony, help me out. Fatten is trying to convince me that I might actually enjoy reading the skid mark of a romance book.
Oh, hell yeah, I love that one.
Get the fuck out.
I'm not like a Martha level super fan. It's like super straight and white, but I don't know, kind of like all the wedding shit.
You kind of like the what?
Oh, the wedding planning stuff. Gets me thinking what I want for mine, you know? Big ass buttercream cake, flowers all over the place, a fancy fucking dinner. Wait, what's it called when it's not a buffet plate? A plate of dinner. I want all that shit.
This is incredible.
Who are you? Who are any of you? Why am I a stranger in a strange land?
Uh-oh. I know what's wrong with you. Your dependents walked off, the shelter is put in place, and for the first time ever, Dorothy has nothing to do.
And that's a problem, because she sucks at leisure.
She's fine at leisure.
Mm.
Where are you going?
To do leisure.
Hey, stranger. Everything all right?
Mm-hmm. Just trying to skin them downwind. Doesn't always smell so great.
Are you sure you're okay? Me and Shelby hanging out and everything, because she told me that maybe you weren't feeling so.
Shelby told you, you told Shelby. That is what I'm not okay with. My shit is my shit, and I want it to stay that way.
Martha, I would never say anything about anything that you wouldn't tell her yourself. Not on my life would I do that.
How about you just tell her nothing? You know, to be on the safe side.
Yeah, of course. Whatever you need.
Sorry. I don't mean
to be... It's cool. That's all cool. I'm so proud of you.
Why?
You've gotten so strong. You're like a fucking warrior.
Whoop, whoop! Surprise!
Yeah, surprised I didn't murder each other in cold blood.
Where'd that come from?
Pulled it out of the water.
What the hell's in it?
Take a look, bet you like it.
Or at least be like mildly amused and confused by it.
Party supplies?
An old person's party.
An old person named Barbara.
Why on earth are y'all acting disappointed? I mean, look at these.
That, yeah. Plastic forks.
Yeah, but they're like the fancy plastic, like full-on dishwasher safe. And aren't you excited to eat with a freaking fork again? Oh my God, how precious are these?
The plates. You're gonna lose your girlfriend to this kitschy party shit. I mean, can you get her off like this?
This Barbara knows how to party. Yeah, honestly, I'm not sure this is a rookie check for me.
Hey, Fatten.
There might be something for you yet.
Okay, I take back all negative commentary. Barbara, you're a fucking legend.
Wait. Is this what I think it is?
Oh, it's a piñata. Hey, Kitty.
Holy shit, Babs, you were gonna beat up your boss in effigy?
Yeah, I can't tell whether that's punk rock or disturbing.
Both.
You okay, Leah?
Yeah, no, I'm good.
Yeah, sorry, it's just the pinata. My dad has this friend named Top Ramen. His name is actually Paul. But we call him Top Ramen because this one time on a ski trip, he got very drunk and snorted like 10 lines of ramen seasoning. That pinata looks just like him.
Wow.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Look, you know Dot's gonna want to inventory the shit out of all.
Yeah. Where is Dot?